work is called Sydney Buddha, and it's by the Chinese artist Zhang. It's a 5.5 meter tall aluminium sculpture. It's a mold of a Buddha, which has been built, and then it's pressed with 20 tons of ash, which has been collected from temples in China. The ash is mixed with water and then is hand pressed into the mold by a team of about 12 people and takes about 5 days. The skin of the mold is then removed and the ash Buddha remains. And what we then do is rebuild the aluminium Buddha opposite the ash Buddha, so the two have a relationship. Zhang is one of the pioneering avant-garde artists who was working at a time when Chinese art came to great kind of international acclaim. And perhaps the most iconic work is a work called 12 Meters Square, where he sat naked in a public latrine and covered himself in fish oil and honey and allowed the insects to come and crawl over him.
Buddhism to Zhang is very central to his body of work. He's a practicing Buddhist himself, so you see varying tones of intensity to which his own Buddhist practice might reveal itself. Through the exhibition period, the ash degrades and shows an aspect of time, whereas the solid aluminum body of the Buddha, the shell, remains in its perfect state.
In about 2008, he went to a temple, and it was at the temple that he noticed the ash fall into the floor, and it spoke to him immediately as a material that wasn't just waste, but really contained the hopes and the prayers and the thoughts of millions of people. And so he wanted to reuse this material in his art rather than throw it away.
Most of Zhang Huan's work, there seems to be an aspect of performance, not only in the cooperation and the communal aspect of creating a work of this scale, but also in the dimension of time.
It takes so many hands and hours to build and to make this work. There's definitely a performative element to it. And it's really the hands and the hours of many for the vision of Zhang Huan, and, you know, a vision that he wants to then speak to millions of people around the world. Part of the enjoyment and part of the process of this work has been the risk that it involves, and the risk of failure and of the work, you know, falling apart. It's actually kind of integral to the philosophy of the work. So the rate of change, whatever happens every day, it really, you know, it really doesn't matter that much, because how you experience it one day will be completely different to how you would experience it another day.